let's revise uses and adverse effects of beta blockers. Beta blockers, as you know, are drugs which selectively or non-selectively block beta receptors. Beta 1 selective are called as cardioselective, and those which block both beta 1 and beta 2 are called as non-selective beta blockers. So we can have cardioselective beta blockers, we can have non-selective beta blockers, we can have beta blockers which have intrinsic sympathomimetic activity, and we can have beta blockers which have membrane stabilizing activity. And all these beta blockers, they are used mainly in cardiovascular conditions, some neurological conditions, a condition of eye, and a condition of thyrotoxicosis. So they have cardiovascular uses, neurological, anxiety, migraine, and tremor related uses, ophthalmic or glaucoma eye related uses. So hypertension is a cardiovascular use, angina pectoris is a cardiovascular use, arrhythmia is a cardiovascular use, myocardial infarction is a cardiovascular use, and myocardial infarction in acute setting, they are used to limit the size of infarct, and in chronic setting they are used to prevent any arrhythmia, prevent sudden death, and if they are given before an event, it's called as primary prophylaxis. If they are given after a cardiac event, it's called as secondary prophylaxis. They are used in pheochromocytoma, and they are used in dissecting aneurysm, and in dissecting aneurysm they have a role only till surgery is performed to limit the size of damage. Also used in hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, and they are used in thyrotoxicosis only to control the symptoms. The basic treatment in thyrotoxicosis will be to use antithyroid drug. Beta blockers are used only for symptomatic control. They are used for essential tremors, they are used for anxiety, they are used for migraine prophylaxis, and they are used for glaucoma. So revising uses of beta blocker: hypertension, angina, arrhythmia, myocardial infarction, pheochromocytoma, dissecting aneurysm, hypertrophic obstructive cardiomyopathy, thyrotoxicosis, essential tremors, anxiety, migraine, and glaucoma. And adverse effects are slowing of heart or bradycardia, precipitation of a asthma which is called as bronchospasm, or exacerbation of Prinz metal angina. So they are contraindicated in Prinz metal angina, whereas they are given in angina or classical angina. They cause carbohydrate intolerance, and they have adverse effect on plasma lipid level. And selective beta 1 selective blocker have less adverse effect on lipid metabolism. So revising beta blockers uses: hypertension, angina, arrhythmia, myocardial infarction, pheochromocytoma, dissecting aneurysm, hypertrophic obstructive cardiomyopathy, thyrotoxicosis, essential tremors, anxiety, migraine, glaucoma, and adverse effects: bradycardia, bronchospasm, exacerbation of Prinz metal angina, carbohydrate intolerance, and adverse effect on lipid profile. And symptoms like tiredness, fatigue, lethargy, reduced exercise capacity, impotence, lack of drive, cold hand and feet. You can differentiate hand of a patient who is taking calcium channel blocker, which will not be cold, and the hand of a patient who is taking beta blocker will be cold. This is because of decreased cardiac output. So tiredness, fatigue, lethargy, reduced exercise capacity, impotence, lack of drive, cold hand and feet, bradycardia, bronchospasm, exacerbation of Prinz metal angina, carbohydrate intolerance, and metabolic adverse effect on cholesterol profile are adverse effects of beta blockers.